leaves of trees on. Will you come home and stop this pain tonight? Stop this pain tonight.
Don't waste your time on me. You're already the voice inside my head. Don't waste your time on me. You're already the voice.
I wish I knew.
I'm back, guys. Giving you the videos that you love. Just gonna kinda do some fun stuff, but mostly analysis this week. Couple funny things to listen for. Next week I'm gonna really try to throw in some skits and make you laugh and give you the good advice that you need for fantasy football as well. Le'Veon Bell, man, screwing anybody that took him this year. He was the big trade and or one league this week, and he was the worst pick in the draft in many leagues, and not much more to say about that. And Dez Bryant, a lot of people bid on that. I was one of the victims of that, and that one screwed you. Anyway, we'll get into the analysis. LaCosta, guys, if you're in the LaCosta League, you can skip past. I'm going to be starting with the original league's analysis. So you can skip to about, I'm going to say, like the 12-minute mark, and then you'll start to hear some of the analysis for the LaCosta League. If not, original league guys, you'll be up now, so enjoy. See you in a sec. All right, guys. Now we can get into some of the analysis on the original league. So, LaCosta guys, skip ahead if you want, or if you enjoy the videos, maybe it gets you some extra help. Listen to the analysis of the league, the original guys. I did my analysis on Wednesday night again, so I've updated some, but basically what I'm doing today is giving you three key points on each side, and they're already done, so I will update them as I go here. But without further ado, let's get into the matchups and the analysis. First game, McGuire comes in 2-7 versus Weber 3-6. McGuire up 39 points already to start the week. And my three keys on McGuire's side, I really like Melvin Gordon going today. I like all of his Eagles to have big games tonight. And I like Tyler Boyd with no A.J. Green. I think they're going to have to try and get him the ball as much as possible. Big Ben had a huge game for McGuire already, and Graham Gano, you didn't get much out of him, but any points are points. On Weber's side, I still think that Zeke Elliott has an average game against a tough Sunday night game in Philadelphia. Eagles defense, good up front, but we'll see, because Zeke is one of the best. Coleman. Can Tevin Coleman repeat his performance last week, or will he be doing more of what he's done to start the season, be a little slow? And Drew Brees, out in the element, will he be as good as his usual self? So there's some things to look at. McGuire's got the lead early on, but I still like McGuire to win this one. 112 to Weber's 104. Way to go, Suds, with your big trade this week. Next up, Mattalone versus Tito. This is a battle of what I like to call the clean guys. You know, they don't like to get their hands dirty. Never really worked in the bar business. Sweck's an honorary bar member. Weber, if you guys listen closely, Weber, he likes to get dirty. Yeah, he does. But, Mattalone, Tito, I like to call this the battle of the clean guys. And as we look into it, Tito with a slight lead, 18 points early on to Mattalone's nothing. For Mattalone, I think Matt Ryan outside, how will he do? He's a dome quarterback. Could struggle a little bit today in the Cleveland lake effect temperatures. Todd Gurley's been a stud all year, and I look for him to continue to roll today. And O.J. Howard, I think, is the third key here. Been doing much better over the past few weeks, and Fitzmagic hasn't hurt him. So I think O.J. Howard, great play this week. On Tito's side of the ball, Aaron Rodgers, Hall of Fame future quarterback. Think he's going to be great. Don't think the weather's too big of a factor, and he's used to it, so I think he has a great game today. Juju already was my second key. He had a solid game. Would have liked to see him get over 100 yards, but still solid game and a touchdown. And then Jason Kelce, one of the top tight ends in the league, if not the top tight end. So I look for him to roll today against Arizona. Madaloni 8-1, Tito 3-6, but still one of the top point getters this year. This is a tough one to call, but I'm going upset special. Tito 111 to Madaloni's 106. Tito takes down the Wicked Witch. Check it out right here. Okay, I hope you like that little shot there at Madaloni. Get a little zinger. Next up, we got Angelo versus Ryan. Angelo, 5-4, been falling off the past few weeks. He's lost 4 of his last 5. So really looking to get a rebound here, and who better to get a rebound against than Ryan's team. Ryan, 3-6, just made a trade. Not a bad trade. You got rid of a guy that's probably not going to play it all this season. And you only waited until week 10 to get rid of him. You lost Dez Bryant in the deal. Matt Breida is probably not playing today. But hey, you got Demaryius Thomas on a bye week. So, no help this week from that trade whatsoever. But maybe next week, right? Looking into it, Angelo, I like David Johnson versus Kansas City. I like the Rams wide receivers to have a big day today. And I think James White still has a good game, even though Sony Michel is due back this week. So he'll probably go from being a plus 20 point guy to middle teens. But still a solid play. Still use him in the receiving game. So I like James White for you this week. On Ryan's side, he's gotten 19 points. 14 of which came from Cam Newton in a terrible game. Pittsburgh blew them out. Not sure who Ryan's second running back was going to be as of Wednesday night, and I did not look because I really don't think it matters. I like Sterling Shepard for you, and my other advice on Wednesday night was get a defense. So, with all that said, I really don't think that Ryan can do anything to help himself in this one. Ange gets the easy win and gets back on the winning side. Angelo 101 to Ryan's 90. Next up, we got Big Kev versus Sweck. Big Kev 4-5, another big point getter, just not seeming to get any luck this year. Sweck dominating the league, even though his 7-2 record might not fully show how well he's done. He's, I believe, right there in the battle for most overall points. He's, congratulations, Sweck. You won the points thing, whatever the hell that was. I really don't agree with it because I think it should have always been that you stayed alive if you weren't the lowest score with everybody considered. But that's just my opinion, and I would have been out the first week anyway. So we can talk about it more next year. But anyway, Sweck got that money. Congratulations. For Big Kev's side, I think Aaron Jones is a solid play. He gets real carries from this point on this season. Olsen really didn't help you much with 6 points, so you're going to have to get some help to make up for that. And Michael Thomas on the road, I think as long as the weather isn't too bad, Drew Brees gets him the ball, and he's a solid play this week. On Sweck's side of the ball, I think Fitz versus a good Washington defense will be something to watch for. It could be more like his game against Pittsburgh, where he had lots of yards, and he'll get his points fantasy-wise, but he'll probably have some negative points mixed in to bring some of that value down. James Conner, got a so-so game, 14 points, basically. So we'll see how the other players on your team can help that issue there. I look for Trey Burton to get in the end zone this week, and I think Sweck pulls this one out. Sweck wins 135 to Big Kev's 127. Finally, D-Bill versus Drew. It's a big game. There's a tight race between me, Drew, and Angelo for the playoff spot, and Angelo has an easy game this week versus Ryan, so that makes me versus Drew all the more important. Going into the game, I had McCaffrey and Antonio Brown as two of my three keys, and they went off on Thursday night and got me solid plays to put me up about 53 points early on. My third play was MVS from Green Bay. I think that he's proven he's a value, and I'm looking for him to have a good day this week against Miami. On Drew's side of the ball, I think Kareem Hunt is a huge play against Arizona's defense. He gets receiving, he gets rushing. He's the Le'Veon Bell of the season this year. I love ODB to get back on track and roll against San Francisco Monday night. And I think injuries are going to be the key question for Drew on how this one turns out. Carson Wentz with some new weapons. We'll see whether that's a bonus for him or a minus. But I think he'll be a solid play versus Dallas. This is going to be close. And I got the big start, which could affect things. But on Wednesday night, I gave Drew the victory here, 115 to Dollar Bill's 108. We'll see if Thursday night was enough to change that. But that's what we're going with. Hope you guys enjoy it. If you want to stick around, I'm going into the LaCosta League next. If not, good luck to everybody and have fun. All right, now we get into the LaCosta League. So, we're going to jump right into it and try to make it quick. First up, the big matchup, me versus Lager. I'm playing Lager in two leagues this week, and both leagues he's in first place. In both leagues, I'm in the playoff hunt. Massive playoff implications for me versus him in two different leagues this week. He got off to a solid start with Antonio Brown and James Conner in our other league, and I got help from Chris Boswell, so I'm hoping I can squeeze him out in that league. But let's get right into this league. Lager, 7-2 versus Dollar Bills, 5-4. He's about 35 points ahead of me, tied for second with Marola in fantasy points. I'm sitting back and forth trying to cut into that. I did most of my analysis. I'm giving three keys on each team. And I did all my analysis on Wednesday night, so I'm kind of updating as I go now that I'm doing a video Sunday morning. From Thursday night, Juju Smith-Schuster has gotten me 19 points, which is a good start. Not a great start, but a good start. On Lager's side of the ball, his three keys, I think. Jordan Howard, will he be the bigger play versus my Tariq Cohen? That'll be a big factor for our game. Alvin Kamara will, in a little bit colder elements, outside. He's become more of the receiving back, so going to have to see whether Ingram steals some points in this weather game or whether Kamara is his usual stud self. And Golden Tate. Will Golden Tate come right out of the gate as an Eagle to remember? Will they work him slowly in this week? We'll see how he factors into this game this week, tonight, versus the Cowboys. On Dollar Bill's side, I got Drew Brees outside the dome. I get a little bit worried about this, so really something to watch there. I'm really hoping for a Monday night shootout so that George Kittle's big for me and Sterling Shepard is big for me. And then I rolled with the Eagles for a home game versus Dallas, Sunday Night Football. Let's go Eagles D, Jake Elliott. I'm looking for it, and I'm going to give Dollar Bill to win 165 to Loggers 143. Next up, Marola versus Jay, the other 7-2 versus 5-4 matchup. Marola comes in 7-2, tied for second in points, playing Jay, the first overall points leader, at 5-4. On Marola's side of the ball, he's already gotten a gigantic game from Christian McCaffrey. He has Tevin Coleman looking to try and have a second big game after last week. Can he get it done at Cleveland? We'll have to see. And then O.J. Howard, a strong play, rolling with the Fitzmagic. O.J. Howard, a good play this week. On Jay's side of the ball, as of Wednesday night, Jay did not have 10 players. I looked real quick. He's fixed that dilemma. So glad you got a full roster now, Jay. My 1A key here was James Conner. He came in kind of as an average game for him. So you lost that kind of stud value, but still an okay play from him. Calvin Ridley outside versus at Cleveland. Going to have to see how Matt Ryan holds up in getting everybody the ball. Could be more of a Julio game. We'll have to see how this one plays out. And I like Jared Goff for you versus Seattle. I think this is going to be a shootout between these two guys. They've proven to be two of the better teams in the league this year. And I like Marola to steal this one. Not by much, but Marola wins 175 to Jay's 163. Next up, the duo versus Jordan. This is a toilet bowl game. It's 2-2-7 teams. We pretty much have nothing to talk about with these teams, so quickly, Jordan got 33 points from the kicker and the Steelers' defense. Good job, Jordan. On your side of the ball, Jordan, I like DJ to have a good game against Kansas City. I like Michelle back against the Tennessee Titans this week for the Patriots. And then Michael Thomas, I think he'll be good against Cincinnati in the cold weather. On the duo side of the ball, I think Wentz, big game to beat up the Cowboys. I look for Zeke to have a solid game against the Eagles. And you went with Cordell Patterson. He's gotten the running back wide receiver designation, but now Michelle's back. I don't know what his value is anymore. With that said, I think Jordan wins this one 142 to the duo's 128. And again, it's a toilet bowl game. Next up, Conway versus DF. Conway 2-7, Le'Veon Bell screwed his season. DF 5-4, looking to hang around in that playoff conversation. DF got a huge game. He played Big Ben over Tom Brady. Honestly, I had Brady as one of my top key threes for DF. He went against it. He put Big Ben in. Smart play. 48 points from Big Ben. Huge day. Now 8 only from Greg Olsen, but DF out to a 56-0 lead with Todd Gurley still yet to come. And I think Aaron Jones, a good play this week against Miami. I believe he gets some real touches finally. I think Rodgers is good for Conway. I think Ingram gets more carries than Kamara in the cold weather for the Saints. And I like Tyler Boyd to get a lot of targets with no A.J. Green in the game. Also, Godwin could be Goodwin could be a difference maker. But I don't think it's enough with the big lead already. DF rolls 145 to Conway's 138. Finally, Blair 4-5, trying to hang around in the playoff conversation versus Chuck's 6-3 team, still staying ahead of the group that's chasing him for the playoff hunt. Chuck comes in with a 21-3 lead going into Sunday. He got 21 points from Antonio Brown, so solid start there. Looking to build off of that. Chuck, with Matt Ryan outside, tough against the elements. We'll have to see how he holds up out there. James White with Sony Michel back, going to be a tough play. And then Gronk. They're waiting on Gronk till like the very last minute. So very tight to see whether he can play Gronk or switch to Goddard. Not looking good for your tight end situation. I do like Joe Mixon this week, so that'll be a great play for you. I think, like I said, the Monday night shootout. So I like Blair to have a big game from Barkley. And I love the Eagles on Blair's team. I think that Randall Cobb should play over Lockett if he's available. If Cobb sits out, then stick with Lockett. You got to go get a defense here, Blair. That was as of Wednesday night, so I'm hoping you obviously got somebody. And I like Keenan Allen for you versus Oakland. I think that'll be a big play. This is going to be tight. It's going to be very close. Chuck has some injury issues. Otherwise, I think he'd be the better team. Blair has some solid matchups to keep him in it. And I'm going to hit the button. Blair, upset special. Blair wins 141 to Chuck's 139. That's going to do it here for Dollar Bill. Good luck to all you guys in Fantasyland. And we'll see you next week with some more fun stuff. Happy to be back. Take care. Don't waste your time.